everyone. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of This Month in Oklahoma, November edition. I hope you all had a great Thanksgiving holiday. The mystery deepened around the disappearance of a Paul's Valley teen this month. A VNN investigation uncovered a paper trail of arrest reports linked to 17-year-old Faith Lindsay's 25-year-old boyfriend, including some unsettling statements given to investigators. According to court documents filed on November 5th, a woman contacted the Seminole County Sheriff's Office on October 29th, stating Tanner Washington told her his girlfriend, Faith Lindsay, had been shot in Sasakwa. Lindsay was last seen on October 28th. You can read the full report in VNN's free plug-in app. OSBI is now offering a $5,000 reward for information in that case. Investigators are also searching for a 33-year-old Altus man. We're told Richard Thurman Hitchcock was last seen in the Granfield area on November 9th near State Highway 54 and U.S. Highway 70 after his car ran out of gas. Anyone with information about either case should call 1-800-522-8017 or email tips@osbi.ok.gov. Hundreds left prison following the largest commutation in this nation's history. In 2016, Oklahoma voters approved a state initiative that reclassified certain drug and property crimes as misdemeanors instead of felonies. Earlier this year, lawmakers passed a bill making those changes apply to people who were already serving felony sentences for those crimes. The mass release marks a striking change for criminal justice reform in Oklahoma. Per capita, the state has the second highest incarceration rate in the U.S., and it locks up women at the highest rate of any state. Before the mass release, state prisons held almost 25,750 people. In-depth coverage of the historic event provided by VNN affiliate The Frontier. Constitutional carry took effect in Oklahoma this month. House Bill 2597 allows Oklahoma citizens 21 or older to carry a firearm in public without a permit, as well as military personnel and veterans over 18. The law still prohibits criminals or mentally ill people to carry a firearm. Private property owners and colleges can still prohibit firearms if they choose. House Bill 2010 is a follow-up bill to House Bill 2597 that allows Oklahoma citizens to carry a firearm on property owned, leased, operated, or managed by a public trust. Open carry in those locations can be prohibited, but permitless concealed carry cannot. 10 people were hospitalized after receiving insulin instead of a flu shot at an assisted living home in Bartlesville this month. It happened at Arc Group Home. Police said a pharmacist came by the living facility for special needs adults to administer flu shots, and recipients started falling ill soon afterwards. 9 people were transported to a local hospital. 1 was taken by private vehicle. All have since recovered. No word if any criminal charges will be filed. After 6 years at its second location, downtown Philbrook is set to close to make room for Bob Dylan Center. CEO and President Scott Stulen told members Philbrook downtown will close to the public on December 29th. Stulen said by focusing on one location, Philbrook will greatly increase their capacity to fulfill their mission to make a creative and connected community through art and gardens. And some exciting news for VNN this month. As Tulsa Public Schools becomes VNN's first self-managed official, TPS spokesperson Lauren Partain told VNN, "We love to spotlight the great teaching and learning happening in our classrooms. We are excited Verified News Network is a platform we can use to share our stories about school and district news, events, programs, and activities." You can read more about what this means in VNN's free plug-in app, available for download for both iPhone and Android. That's where you'll find more about all of these stories, plus many more. Verified News, all facts, no bias or opinion, news and weather. That's all for now. Until next time, I'm VNN's Brittany Harlow. We'll see you next month.